Table Tennis Illustrated, and he will give us his impressions of how he thinks this final of the 2009 Pro Tour Series is going to go. Ian.
Well, thank you very much indeed, John, and like you, delighted to be here in Macau. Two absolutely wonderful table tennis players. There we see Goyan Servin, the right-hander. She's the more powerful of the two players, and I would suggest maybe the most powerful of all the leading ladies in the world of table tennis. Whereas Ding Ning, as we've seen before today, she's very, very fast, very quick indeed. So Goyan, the defending champion, and she's playing the young lady who just 1 month ago became the Asian champion. And I'm not so sure, John, that Goyan is the clear favourite. I think, yes, we might just give her the vote, but Ding Ning has nothing to lose. She's everything to prove, and she takes no prisoners.
That is for sure. We just saw that. She takes an absolutely extraordinary four-point lead in the first game. But one of the things that really turns me on to Goyan is the way she demolished Kim Kyung Ah in the semi-final. That was really quite surprising.
Well, that's right. I saw Goyan play Kim Kyung Ah in the English Open, and I think it was 4-2 to Goyan. But the first three, four games of that were a real battle until Goyan got on top. But today, Goyan played tactically extremely well against Kim Kyung Ah. She played to the forehand all the time. She concentrated attacks on the weaker side of Kim Kyung Ah. Very disciplined approach.
And the score with 6-7, 5-7. And that was, well, in terms of the Koreans' experience, that was a demolition.
Well, it was just thoroughly professional. Absolutely professional in the best sense of the word.
Well, Ding Ning has had the best of the opening exchanges, leading by five. But now Goyan has fought back and has picked up 2 points. So let's just examine how these players are going to react, because they're certainly, they know each other's game so well. That's the biggest problem when you have players of the same nationality. They work out, they train with each other. And of course, although there's a lot more experience in Goyan, the benefit that Ding Ning would have had in working with these more experienced players is immense.
Well, that's right. They're both at the National Training Center in Beijing, which I think it's something like five stories of table tennis facilities, starting with the gymnasium, then to the administration, then to the men's training center with some 30 tables, then another floor for rehabilitation or whatever, then another floor for the women, and some 30 tables. And every single one, I've been there, every single one is international standard. Everything is correct. The last detail is perfect. So if you get everything right with your training, there's no wonder you play well in international competition.
One of the things that I've noticed, and in fact I commented on in the semi-final, was this young lady on screen. She plays more like a man, to be quite honest. The speed, absolutely unbelievable. Look at that. That could have been who? Zhu Jin?
Oh, we're in the exhibition world now. Look at that. That ball faded away wide to the forehand, so no chance. But no, Ding Ning's speed, and that's one thing that I think we've seen here with the younger generation, shall we say the new generation of Chinese players, they're so fast. Here comes the service, John. You like this, I think.
Yeah. Seriously, you have to tell me, I've been calling it a Ouija type serve. There is a Japanese.
That's the coach's name.
Yeah, there you go. I read about it at the World Championships in Yokohama last year. And, well, every time we see it, it's very effective, isn't it? Extraordinary.
Well, that's right. The bat arcs, and it depends where on the racket you hit the ball to create backspin or topspin. Or perhaps just say maybe not topspin so much, but no spin.
Ding Ning has taken this first game by the scruff of the neck. It's 3-10. And that is the game. It's amazing. And that was 2 years ago, the Swedish Open, and it was Goyan that won.
Yeah, she won 4-0.
4-1.
4-1. 4-1, is it?
Oh, well done. Listen, I'm looking at the notes, and you're just...
I know that Goyan won very, very easily, but you have to take into account, I think it was one of the first or second ITTF Pro Tour events. She'd only be 16, 17 years old
17.
At the time.
Yeah.
Now here's the service. Just see the racket arc round. Oh yeah, puts an amount of side spin on the ball and can vary between no spin, hot spin, and heavy backspin.
One all in the second. Guo Yan needs to settle. That's not settling.
Not in a rhythm, is she?
No. Mind you, Ma Long took some time too today.
Well, he went 2-0 down, didn't he? And he made some uncharacteristic mistakes close to the net, but once he was in a rhythm, it was like just stopping that hydrofoil going across to Hong Kong.
Hong Kong just 40 clicks away, I think.
That's not far, is it? No, it's...
2-2 in the second. We're live in Macau. The Pro Tour Grand Finals from the 2009 season. We start the 2010 season in a couple of weeks in Slovenia. Covering this final on terrestrial TV. We've also got some satellite takers as well. And of course, the ITTF website is proving very popular this weekend. We're attempting to give the fans, the table tennis fans worldwide, all the opportunity to see some great play. And this is streaming live with our commentary as well, Ian. So that's a great thrill, isn't it? It's a lovely innovation, technology coming to greet the fans.
It's the future, isn't it? It is the future, and the opportunities, I think, are immense.
3-4, Ding Ning still holding sway in the second. You know, Guo Yan, she won the point there. She was pretty excited at doing that, so it just shows she's a little bit tense.
Well, she's a defending champion. To win this 2 years in a row would be something very, very special for any table tennis player. And that could be if you're the great Zhang Yining, the Olympic and world champion, or Wang Hao, the world champion, Marlin, the Olympic champion. To win the ITTF Pro Tour Grand Finals consecutive years would be a phenomenal achievement.
Ding Ning finds the edge there, the back edge of the table. So a little bit of good fortune running with her as well. You need that too. Extraordinary service. Oh, the speed, the power. Guo Yan knows how to play it. Ultimately wins it to level things at five, but wow. They don't like standing back from the table, do they?
No, well, of course, with the greatest respect to these two fine ladies, they don't have the power of the men. So very much the attacking player, the modern-day attacking player in table tennis on the women's side stays close to the table. Now, we've seen in these last 2 or 3 points, Tom, the tactics of Guo Yan. She's played nearly 90 to 95% of her strokes into the body of Ding Ning, into the backhand. Now, that's not to say that Ding Ning's backhand is weak. It's the forehand is so good, so electric, so fast, so much topspin, so much rotation on the table tennis ball. Ooh, she's looking.
Yes, she was. Trying to put a little bit of extra spin, took the pace off, but the ball just kept going.
I think you said the magic word there, the spin on the ball, the spin into Ding Ning's backhand, just to try to slow things down a little bit, is sure the tactic that Guo Yan must employ. If she plays fast to the backhand or fast to any side, I think Ding Ning is going to be very, very happy indeed. If she can just slow things down a little by heavy topspin first ball, then I think she can come back into this match. Good physical look from Ding Ning. Both play for Beijing.
I guess they'd be quite glad to be playing in Macau at the moment because it's pretty chilly up
there. So they tell me that's right. The people from the ITTF office in Beijing are telling me it's been minus 11, minus 12, so they're quite happy in Macau. 8-6. I think in Europe it's not so good either, no. By what we're hearing on the news.
We've both had trouble getting here, and I think we'll have trouble getting back as well. There's huge blizzard storms. Guo Yan has taken the lead in the second. And now she's getting into a rhythm just at the right point of the game. She's got the service as well at 9-6. This is an important couple of serves. Put down the mark after that first game, which is a bit of a disaster. Oh, the angle on that. And she was favourite because the ball sat up there, but what an extraordinary angle. Look at this. Amazing, and still going away from her.
Well, that's right, and whilst it might look easy on those television screens, it wasn't that simple. She had to move, she had to get in position, make sure she was well balanced, and then not panic.
Full flow of the body, the arms in particular. Yeah, look at those legs working.
Oh. And look how quickly she changed the direction of play. Out to the forehand, then to the backhand. And there you saw Ding Ding. That is the strength of Ding Ding from the forehand. She puts a lot of rotation on the table tennis ball. And also she changes direction very, very quickly. And she's very accurate.
Getting close. 8-9. Oh, lucky, lucky. Okay, just for our viewers... information here. Had that ball gone back over off a thrown bat, it would not have counted.
No, you have to hold the racket.
Thank
That's
you.
Correct.
So there was not much point in throwing it.
Okay, you've just become an international umpire. Congratulations.
10-8. Game point, but no, it caught the edge there. It's 9. Ding Ding will not go away, will she? She's been invited here, but it's into Guo Yan's house at the moment because she is defending champion. Now, let's see whether or not she's going to have any charity hosting her in Macau. Ah, good work, yes, and she's excited. To both those criteria, it's 3. Game 3, it's 1-1.
One love.
She's strong. Just look at those shoulders, eh?
That's right.
Muscular.
Guo Yan was asked why she took up table tennis after she found she could play a little bit and she had some talent for the sport. She decided she wanted to be famous.
Is that
the
right?
The way to be famous was to play table tennis, so she's on her way.
Well, she's gone beyond her country boundaries, that's for sure.
I just feel a little bit sorry for Guo Yan at times. She was almost the number 4 player for the Olympic team. She wasn't selected, missed out on World Championships. She's very much sort of the bridesmaid, the lady in waiting, and... to some extent, you have sympathy for Guo Yan, you're delighted when she does well, and she doesn't have bad losses or anything like that. I think the last time I saw the surprise defeat was something like 2003, the World Championships in Bercy, in the suburbs of Paris, when I believe she lost to the Romanian, Attila Badescu, but other than that, I can't remember her losing to anybody from outside China.
It's dead men's boots or dead women's boots, isn't it?
To some extent, yes. I mean, just bear in mind, 2005 in Shanghai World Championships, she was the runner-up to Zhang Yining. And we found Guo Yan sitting in a corner by herself, crying her eyes out that she'd lost in the final. She was absolutely distraught. She'd lost in the final of a World Championships, number 2 in the world. Dear me, what a disaster.
Expectations are high all round, though.
She desperately wanted it. Absolutely desperately wanted to be world champion.
3-all. Well, of course, with Ying Ning off the scene, Wang Nan now. I mean, they're still in the reckonings, in the rankings. So much.
Well, yes, we have to wait and see what Zhang Yining does. I mean, she was recently married. But I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see Zhang Yining back next year.
Li Jiawei has taken it one step further. She got married and had a baby.
Sorry here.
I wonder if she's watching. If she is, congratulations. think they would ever be watching table tennis again after being right in the middle of it for so long.
Well, Li Jiawei might be interested, because Guo Yan's from Beijing, the same city as Li Jiawei.
4-all in the third, and this is definitely a big, big psychological moment, I think. Who can get the third? Didn't appear to be much on that. It was just overstruck.
Just a little. This was Guo Yan's service. It's a very, very exaggerated stance. And must sometimes just be near the mark for seeing the ball. The left arm comes away quickly, so quite legal. But very exaggerated stance. Now we see again how she doesn't quite turn her back to the table. She's approaching that angle.
And the point that you're making there, of course, is that the ball has got to be visible at the service.
Right, I think.
Yeah,
that's right.
But the pen holders also push it to the limit, don't they? My gosh.
I think that is the nature of sport.
Right, well, she's got the ball and got the lead in the third at 6-4. Fantastic rally continues. A little bit of extra speed on that left-hander's backhand, and it does the job.
I think since I've seen Ding Ding play, that is the major improvement in her play. I was impressed with the backhand on the first attack when she played Feng Tang Wei. And certainly, that for me is a major improvement. Also, as a junior, she relied heavily on this service then, following up with a strong forehand. And of course, playing senior players, they're a little wiser.
Well, Guo Yan has struggled a little bit in this third again. It's really been a bit of a seesaw battle. 4-8, she's got the serve, and desperately needs now to make a few points. And you do for one.
If she goes out for forehand, John, she's got to go out very, very strongly. So maybe the service will not be a backspin service, but a short service with no spin. Expect a higher return and then go out very hard to the forehand.
Going to crack. Well, it wasn't a question of cracking. She had no option. There was no way she was going to get that one back. Guo Yan faults at the net, but it was that brilliant, positive play, aggressive play from Ding Ning that causes that. Look at that, that forehand. Wow. Extra bit of space and pace.
That's right. That's right.
She's got the lead at 9-5. That's a big lead in the third. She went for it, missed it.
Yes, but these last 4 or 5 points, Ding Ning has been the more active player. I think you could even see it just in the footwork. Ding Ning is moving that little bit faster. Guo Yan just a trifle passive.
With a result, that Ding Ning has got the service and the lead at 10-5. And this is game point. Guo Yan, nothing to lose now. She can go for broke. She's really got to get things fired up. 4 points still required to force any problems in this third game. Surely that's too much. And there, exactly what she did before. It was another game point, of course. It's still 3 game points, but big fight. I bet she wishes she'd done it a little bit earlier. A bit tentative in this game, but now she's got nothing to lose. It's all coming good again. That's it. It's 11-7.
And thinking of the ITTF Pro Tour, the first ever ITTF Pro Tour, Kong Lee won it in the men's singles in Kettering, England. And then later that year, he was the first winner of the men's singles event at the Pro Tour Grand Finals when we played in Tianjin, and Kong Lee won on that occasion.
So you've actually followed his career, not only as a player, but then as a coach.
That's right, yes, yes. And as we said before, for me, the most complete table tennis player of all, Kong Lee.
We concentrate now on the women's singles final here in Macau. And in this fourth game, Ding Ning took the opener. But then another little shout of success from Guo Yang. 1-1. There's no variation to her positioning of the serve. It's always there, right in the corner. Whereas, of course, Ding Ning can, although she fluffs that one for 2-1 Guo Yang. This crazy Ouija serve that we see, it does, you can actually vary the position that you play it from. And that adds another dimension of problem.
Well, innovation, adaptation can all contribute to success in any sport.
And the way in which we saw Guo Yang play against, well, the consummate chopper defender Kim Kyung-ah earlier, she had to improvise, that's for sure, but she just managed to dominate her opponent on that occasion. Very impressive. And of course, you mentioned that there's lots of ways of playing this game. There certainly are. And we've witnessed it this week. Look at that. Amazing camera angle. I like this one.
Well, that's good tactics from Guo Yang. She played virtually the whole of that point into the backhand court. Kept Ding Ning under pressure, returned that fantastic forehand, and then managed to win the point.
And through the middle line, it's 1-4. And again, a little to think about for Ding Ning.
Different service. That time hitting the ball with the forehand side of the racket, as opposed to the backhand side. Service technique, very popular in the early 1970s. A Yugoslav player, I suppose I should say Croatian, Dragutin Zurbek, used to use that service quite a lot. Into the body. Ooh, she's gone to the forehand. Careful, into the body. That's better, Guo Yang.
It's spotting the opportunity, taking the opportunity, but the timing is the most important. Look at that. Fabulous.
A good spin on the ball as well, so that very much put Ding Ning into the passive mode.
Guo Yang with the serve at 5-2. I want to be famous. I love that.
That's right, that's what Guo Yang said, bless her, yes. And if you go and just ask her to empty your pockets, I think you might find she keeps a coin in her pocket.
Oh,
a
really?
Little superstitious, yeah. She normally had a coin in the pocket this boy, yeah.
Well, she won't be spending a penny at the moment. She'll be really intent on getting this championship title. She's 2-1 down at the moment, but 2-6 in the lead in the fourth. We don't know who Chai Yo's for.
That's right. Well, the one who needs more steam at the moment is Ding Ning, so okay, look, Chai Ho Ding Ning.
Ding Ning Chai Yo.
Okay. Okay. Your Chinese is better than mine.
No, it's not, I can assure you of that. Ask anyone here. It's 2-7. The shouts of encouragement are certainly giving the crowd something to murmur about. That's 8.
Well, that was a much more positive draw, yeah. Much more positive.
I think she realised when she was down, what was it, 10-7 in the last game, and then suddenly she was playing with a lot more freedom and it worked. It's now working in the fourth. Ay, ay, ay.
The one thing things let loose with that forehand early in the rally, I think Goyon is always going to be second best.
Couldn't get the angle anywhere near it, could she? It just absolutely flew off the bat. 8-3, still a good lead in the fourth. We want finals to go all the way, don't we?
Absolutely. The final of the Women's World Cup, which saw Goyuwei play Lucy Wen, was a fantastic match.
Lucy Wen, another of the great juniors coming through, in fact, the number one world ranked at the moment. Yeah.
I mean, we saw two Chinese players, we forgot they were Chinese. We forgot they were players from the same country. It was a fantastic match.
It's 10-3, well, 3-10 because Ding Ding will serve it, but it's been a significantly improved performance in this game by Guo Yang. Got the edge for the last point, but she'll be very, very happy with what's going on. It doesn't matter, you see. Takes the pressure off when you've got such a great lead. You've invested, you've put your money in the bank, and now you can withdraw when you want it. Yep, that's it. It's 11-4, and what a good recovery that is.
Chinese coaches have told me that Goyuwei's backhand is the weaker side, but, well, okay, weak, but she did become world champion.
But she was a weak world champion. Oh. I can't believe you said that.
Absolutely dreadful backhand.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. Horrendous.
No, just interesting. Yeah.
Who would want one?
I was in Hebei at a trading centre in Shijiazhuang, and the coach of a young lady called Niu Jianfeng, who played Olympic Games 2004, we were discussing players. I said, yeah, I always believe I have a good chance of going away because her backhand's not that strong. I thought, well, dear me, there's a few million players in the world who like Goyuwei's backhand. But at that level, perhaps, and there we go. But Goyuwei, 2007, world champion.
Yeah, it was a fantastic victory. Remember that one. Poor dear. It was a great, well, for me, it was absolutely stunning. I did the World Team Championships in Bremen just the year before, but in Zagreb at 2007 was fantastic. Loved it. Well, it's an interesting time in this final of the women's in Macau because, for the first time, Guo Yan is in the lead overall. 2-2 and 1-2. And it's now leveled at 2-2 and 2-2. Lots of interested parties all around, of course. I'd like to mention here all the volunteers that do such a great job at all these events. They really do rally round and put on a great show for everybody. Ding Ding picks up 3 points in a row. And again, there's momentum, isn't it? It flows one side,
that's
then
right.
The other.
And all the previous games, this sort of stage, one player's got away 3 points and then gone on to win the game. So let's see what happens. Oh, dear.
It's unusual. She shaped up to be in control there. It wasn't a forced shot. It was an unforced error. Ding Ding, 4 points in a row.
She didn't quite anticipate, did she?
Oh dear. What a change of direction.
Very good use of the table and very positive indeed. And she's really now on a run of success. She was 2-1 down.
She was 2-love down, actually.
2-love down, yep, was she? And, yep. Now, what, 5-2 up? Yep. So that's a good run of 5 points. That must have certainly helped her mentally.
Yeah. Well, what a change. Difficult to know, and I'm sure that Guo Yang will have a little sort of puzzling feel about the game at the moment. What did I do wrong there? 2-love up, 6-2 down. Did it catch the net? It might just have caught the top of the net as it was driven through. But there's not much chance for spinning here. It's all drive stuff, isn't it? My gosh.
Yes, and there you saw the immense consistency of both players. Okay, somebody eventually has to lose the point, but compare the Chinese with the rest of the world. Don't get involved in rallies. Try to win the point quickly against them. That's your best chance.
Well, I didn't think we would be witnessing this. Guo Yan, having just won the fourth game, in the fifth, has lost 8 points on the trot.
I think that's one thing about table tennis now, that we play to 11 points as opposed to a decade ago when it was 21. Things change so quickly, John.
Of course, you've got, and there's a ninth point now.
Wow.
We've got that expedite rule, which must have had some kind of influence in terms of, you know, strategy. The Koreans have still got that... I think she's the expedite queen, isn't she?
Well, if the two Koreans play each other, they actually ask the umpire to start at expedite. They start from 0-0 at expedite. Yeah, yeah.
This is stunning. Absolutely brilliant stuff. 10 points in a row. When was the last time? Oh, come on, here you go. We'll be having to search your great memory bank here. The last time that Guo Yang lost 11 points in a row. It's never happened, is it?
I've seen her win 10 in a row and then kindly give the next one away.
Oh, right, okay. But here you go. This is something special. It's there! 11 points in a row.
She was very, very heavily beaten by Zhang Li.
First point, she gets it, she breaks the sequence. So an enforced timeout does the job. It's a bit extreme, I must say. At 3-2, she's got to win the next two to retain her title. I must say, it's good to see the crowd in here. There's a big banner in the back there with Chinese writing. And of course, Macau, very, very popular with mainland Chinese coming over. There's lots of distractions in this country. Or this SAR, I should say now.
That's right, that's right. Very little Portuguese spoken, mostly Cantonese, isn't it? All the road signs are in Portuguese. Yeah.
The old town's very nice. I quite enjoy wandering around. Not too far from where we're based at the moment.
That's right.
A new part with these huge casinos, the Venetian and the like. Well, I mean, they are quite extraordinary. Have you managed to go and see any of those?
Just come back with the Sports Development Council for dinner. It was
a splendid
experience.
Wow.
Yes.
There you go. Amazing. You can't talk about it too much to friends back in England because they won't believe it.
Absolutely incredible it is.
And immediately the lyric was Trouble in Sight. I don't know whether you heard that. But
that's right. Yeah, well spotted.
It's on the table, it's well in sight. Well, you could say that was a good timeout then, because the rot has been stopped for a moment at least. 2-4. Yan's push shot is taken very early, isn't it? That backhand particularly, but she's pushed back off the table and ultimately Ding Ning, well, you can tell from her body language, she's really disappointed with that rally. But gosh, great excitement for all of us just watching.
Well, the last 2 points, Guo Yan's won long rallies, and there's a vote for keeping the ball on the table. I know we say keep the ball on the table. I mean, Guo Yan's keeping that ball on the table at a fair rate of knots as well.
Early push is what I noticed just now on the backhand particularly, but...
Just kicked the net, did it?
Yeah. That's why she's so disappointed.
And now that little stroke look could be absolutely crucial.
Well, considering she's 3-2 down at the moment...
Well, it's the difference between 3-5 and 4-4.
you're a history teacher, not a mathematician. Now, come on, don't go.
That's true. Oh, lovely math. Yes. That's why I'm not an umpire, actually, John.
Let's not get silly. We're in serious mode here. We've got the Macau finals of the 2009 Pro Tour Series. So we're well into January in 2010. 2 weeks' time, we start the whole process again in Slovenia. But at 5-all, even I can work out that they're level. Wears her heart on her sleeve a little bit, this ding ding, doesn't she?
She's sure. She's an outgoing young lady. Very personable.
Do you think she will take a time out if Bo-Yan gets close?
No, I think she's leading, you see, by 3-2. Okay, she comes back to 3-3. She might save her time out for the seventh game.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Unless it gets to something like 10-10, 11-10, match point, yeah, then think about it.
This is a great recovery, isn't it?
Well, from 4-1 down and the disaster of the fifth game.
Yeah. She's obviously coached herself very well, talked to herself, and managing her expectations very, very nicely. That's gone. 1 point the difference now.
Well, now Ding Ding, one serve to come. If Goyang can just get this point, then two serves to come. She could well level matters. Big point.
Let 6-7.
You probably did mention it, but I've got a note here about Goyang's victory over Zhang Yining in the World Cup. In Urumqi, did you
miss
that one?
Yes, I spoke to Goyan after that, and to beat Zhang Yining was so, so special. Great to win the Women's World Cup, but to beat Zhang Yining, well, it's like this in every sport, isn't it? There are these icon figures, and to beat them is memorable, memorable, memorable.
So she's just got to tap into that memory of what she felt like there in order to come away with victory here. It's 8-6 in the sixth. Three more points and we'll force a rubber. Good stuff. Keep your mouth closed, Burgess. It really was exciting.
Now I think here is a case you absolutely go back to basics. Short service, then try and spin the first ball to the backhand, put the pressure on your opponent. I don't think you take risks in these situations with the long service. I think she'll serve short, try and spin that first ball. Well, she did, but what a fantastic response from Ding Ding. Give credit to the 19-year-old.
Absolutely stunning, isn't it? That's 8-all. Fat, fat. Well, that's what I learned in Singapore anyway. Fat, fat.
Okay.
It's the number 8, right? No, it is. It is the number 8.
Oh, well, that's eight. One up for you.
But it means it's lucky, lucky.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not one over the 8.
No, no. Okay. That's why 8 is so lucky in Chinese
now then.
Sort of culture. Who will it be lucky for?
Oh, she's missed it. 8-9. Oh, dear. That is one of Ding Ding's strength, that forehand topspin. Perhaps just a tinge of pressure.
Little bit of pressure. Yeah, she's been dishing it out. Now she's having to take it.
That's right.
Got another serve, though, to put it right here. 8-9. And she has.
Just
9-all, and it's crunch time for Goyan. She's got the ball for the serve. She desperately needs to hold on here. No mistakes here because she's 3-2 down. And another 2 points, and we crown a brand new champion who's still a teenager. Ooh, and that is match point now for Ding Ning. And listen to the crowd. Real pressure here on Goryan. Come on, yes or no? What do you think? Quick?
Yes.
Okay.
I think Ding Ning will win.
Right. There you go. You've heard it from the Goryan. Oh, how lucky is that? You didn't feature the net, the line, the edge of the table. Oh man, can you believe that? Ding Ning just walks away in disgust.
Now for me, Ding Ning did everything perfectly correctly. Put that ball on the table, make your opponent play, don't take a risk. And that's life.
It is life. It's 10-all. Sometimes it's not quite fair. Wow. Still got another chance, of course. She's got the serve. We go alternate serves now. Oh, yes, that is brilliant. Goryan, she's been given just the nearest of a lifeline. And will she take it now? She's got the game point. She's not bursting into tears at the moment, that's for sure.
No, but to be fair to Goryan, looking at this match, I think that's about the only stroke of luck she's had. All the other nets and edges have actually gone the way of Ding Ning, so somewhere the gods of sport have worked.
Game point, sixth game. This to force a rubber. Oh, what happened there?
Dear me. Oh.
Gee, there's even a little smile there from this Wong. Ay, 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 ay. Unbelievable. 11 all. It's tense, it's tight, it's great fun. Great fun unless you have to say that. Playing it. Hey, come on. It is great fun, it's fantastic. Even the cameraman is having fun in the background.
That's
there.
Right, yeah.
Ooh, net and out, 12-11. Ding Ning's had her chances. Yeah, and it's nothing to do with the ability to play this game. It's all about mental strength at the moment. They've all got the great shots in the book. They know how to play. It's time and place. Goryan, 12-11, with the serve.
Joker.
Man.
You are joking.
Yeah. Well, there are some moments in your life when you think, oh. If you've got luck like that going with you, amazing. And you could be right, those moments that just are so, so infinitesimal. They're so small, but they can have such a big effect.
Absolutely incredible.
Now, the teenager, is she old enough, wise enough, does she want it enough? Ooh, bit lucky there, I think, because Goryan was all over it.
Oh, that's right, the ball was there to be flicked, it was high over the net, and tactically she played very astutely, yes, but just flew long. I'm surprised that Ding Ning has consistently used this service. It's not really gained any massive advantage. I would have thought to go back to a more orthodox manner of serving and then just bring that one out maybe later.
It was a super point. It was the first time that we've seen her play the forehand, which is her strength, and she couldn't hold it. She could not find the table. But you're probably right, because we've seen more, since that service, we've seen more rallies.
That's right.
Than perhaps we've been used to. Ding Ning got away with it just a little bit more against Feng Tian Wei. She's not managing it quite so often here.
I mean, Goryan's read the service every time. Not miss me.
It's because they play each other perhaps quite a lot. That's level things at 2-2. And your prediction still has great, great opportunity to be realized. Ding Ning, well, she is the future.
She's hungry.
Yeah. How many times? That's three.
Dear me.
Three and about 6 points, and they have, well, good fortune.
It used to be Houdini to win this match.
Houdini, who done it?
That's right. One wonders how the final point will be decided. Net, edge?
No, it's going to be a really positive shot anyway.
A really ripper. Okay.
Yeah. Like that. That'll do. That'll
absolutely
do for the final one, won't it?
Absolutely. Yeah. Something like that. That's right.
That's what we want. Unbelievable. And it was from a very difficult position, right in front of the body.
Yeah.
Gosh.
But that stroke is possibly the key. If Ding Ning plays strongly from the backhand, it perhaps just gives her the advantage, because Guo Jian has concentrated her attacks principally into Ding Ning's backhand.
It's threes in the seventh. And having to lean away there, it's always into the body. It's not good enough from Guo Jian. Too strong from Ding Ning, and I think she's composed herself again. She's got that focus, she's got that movement, which means, yep, okay, I can do this.
Yes, but she's played 2 points strongly from the backhand. I think that's the crucial point.
Still persisting with this really crazy serve. Well, not crazy, it's not a crazy serve, it's a brilliant serve.
Now she's more positive, John.
Yeah. Here you go. We've seen a change. We've seen a change of attitude, of success, and now a change of ends.
Now again, you change in the deciding game, in this case the seventh game, the player who changes 5-3, 5-4, it's just that little mental boost again, all these little things add up.
It's 3-5, Guo Jian.
Good spin, good spin. That wasn't, you know, too big an error from Ding Ning. Okay, she made the mistake, but the spin on the ball forced the error.
The huge poster that we occasionally see in the cutaways behind. It's great pictures, I must say. It's the kind of thing you'd probably have on your bedroom wall, wouldn't it? Because you're such a fan. I'd say Ma Long and Timo Boll. And I think we saw Ma Lin as well. I'll look it out for it. I'll see if I can take it home with me for you.
Thank you.
Well, that is a huge error of play and of judgment there by Guo Jian. She was all over it. She had a chance. And as has happened before at the other end just a while ago, she pushed it long.
Good recovery there, because again, that's what I would want to see from Ding Ning, playing strongly from the backhand. But Guo Jian responded, got into the rally, and then won the point by playing again with heavy topspin to the backhand. Certainly, in my opinion, Guo Jian's going to win this. Heavy topspin to the backhand is the key. If Ding Ning's going to win, she's got to be positive from the backhand.
Fantastic. Super rally. Absolutely brilliant to level things at 6-6. And Guo Jian lifts her left arm in triumph there. It was superb. Gosh. Well, it befits a final, that's for sure.
Well, absolutely. Look at the extent they're using the legs. And that just shows how fit you have to play table tennis.
She was down, one of those shots, she was down on her knees.
Absolutely.
Extraordinary. 6-6. Great final. Well, we said the Ding Ning Feng Tian Wei, and don't forget they've already played today already. That's extraordinary. Fitness level supreme.
Into the backhand go, yeah.
Did you say no mistakes?
Oh, I think that just Yeah?
Yeah, it did. He touched the net on the way over.
Well, what do you expect?
Yeah, but it was the other way this time, so that's okay. Me.
But we've seen an incredible number of points in the last 5-6 minutes that have been nets, edges, and that perhaps just shows the high quality that these ladies play at. So close over the net.
There's not much looping going on, that's the thing. It's very, very hard and fast and low. How many more times? It's real, real entertaining. We're on the edges of our seat. It's just so cool.
Oh, that's absolutely world class.
7-7, seventh game. You maybe should go to the casino tonight. There you go.
You think so?
7-7-7.
7, okay. I could be my lucky night, could it? Okay.
They can tremendous. Vary it at that kind of pace, that speed, that control. It's wondrous. And the stretch on the forehand, just a little bit too half and far for Guoyan. Ding Ning edges into the lead again. What a great battle.
And just remember, Ding Ning still has a timeout to come if she needs it.
She's taken the point at 9-7. 7-9 now. That really is a huge, huge moment.
Just remember, I think Guoyan two services to come.
The defending champion, Guoyan, everyone expected her to be right at the top of the tree. Number 4 in the world against the number 7 of Ding Ning. Ding Ning is the one that's coming up the ladder. Ooh! She fell off a rung there. She didn't quite fall off the ladder, but she certainly just tripped as she was trying to get to the top.
Didn't quite use the legs, not quite, but easier said than done sitting here, John.
Why do you think I'm doing
that? Absolutely.
8-9, 8-9. Well, if you get the impression we're having fun in here in Macau, you're absolutely right. Look at that. Every rally. And listen to what the crowd think as well. They were out for applauding before the rally was complete.
Now, Ding Ning wants to take time out.
She is taking her time out. Again, China v China, but we don't care. It's brilliant stuff. 9-all. And it's gone. Guoyan could be defending here. Ding Ning cannot believe it. She stands there absolutely dumbfounded. But Guoyan, look at her. Her whole strength is right there in this point, I can tell you. It's not just her experience. It's not just how good she has been grown up in this game. There's a moment in time, and it's right here, and it's now. And she wants it desperately. It's 9-10. Match point, championship point, gold medal point, and it's there! Guoyan! Wow, what about that? She has...